Witkowski back in the lineup after sitting out the last game with a shoulder problem. And immediately, an altercation takes place. And right in the thick of it, Tiger Williams and Al Secor.
That has been a matchup throughout this series. In fact, the team that Al Secor is worrying more about Tiger Williams than just playing his game. He has failed to score any points, and Tiger has certainly done his job.
103, the time remaining in that double minor to Secor and Tiger Williams. Here's a chance for Savard. He's going in alone. Saved by Brodeur. What a playoff series Richard Brodeur is having.
Here's the puck bouncing loose at center ice. Savard picking it up and all the way from the red line nearly walks in. Look at Brodeur standing there. Right. Made Savard make his first move.
Well, he was well out. That shows you the reflexes of Brodeur as he just stuck that pad out as he has time and time again.
Rhoda trying to center it. It comes back to the line. Over to Moline. Moline back to the other side. Bellin with a drive. He scores!
That was deflected in front. It looked like Jim Mill was just to the side of the net. And Bellin, who started things rolling for the Canucks in Vancouver on a nifty pass, this time unloads one from the point. The Canucks do a good job of moving that puck around. It'll come back to Bellin. Now look at the position that Jim Mill will get, and just changes direction, and the puck slides by Bannerman for a 1-0 lead.
Well, Bellin did well. The Canucks were very patient. They moved the puck around. He gets the puck away quickly here. He doesn't take wind up with that real long back swing, but he got it away quick, and he didn't allow the Chicago player to deflect it until it got in front of the net.
Actually, Bobby, it looked like Vancouver were very fortunate because both defensemen were quite a ways apart, and it was a slow pass. Might have been intercepted, but...
Back to the point for Feenster. He's got a good shot. He fired it wide. Preston was looking for the deflection. Sharpley goes into the corner with Hallward, then Snips comes in, and now Hallward and Sharpley are going at it, and we have a jam up in the corner. From the early indications, this is going to be a rough one tonight at Chicago Stadium.
You just have a smile on your face. Do you anticipate something like this, Mr. Hull?
I thought if the Blackhawks didn't come out and get the lead early or play even up with the Canucks, something like this would happen. They've got to keep this crowd behind them. If they can't do it by scoring, they're going to do it by taking bodies.
Well, I think Sharpley trying to convince referee Ron Wick that Hallward and Smith used a little unnecessary force in ramming him into the boards in the corner. Hallward will be going off, and here Smith will be going off, and Sharpley will also be heading off for the Blackhawks. The Hawks back into their own zone, trying to set it up with Savard. He can motor once he starts. There's the drive, and it hits the defender in front of the net. And the penalty coming up against Secor. In comes Chikar. Vancouver, they score! Dan Smeal on a delayed penalty call. A delayed penalty was being called on Al Secor as Vancouver broke out, and Smeal scores to make it 2-0.
Well, you'll see the Canucks break out with Dan Smeal crossing that blue line. He'll take a shot, get his own rebound, penetrate towards the net, fire that shot low, and in it goes. And that's something that the Canucks are quite happy about, but who would have expected it?
Well, I think likely, Gary, that maybe Greg Fox backed in maybe just a little bit too far. He gave Smeal just a little bit too much room to go in.
28 seconds remaining in the penalty to Glenn Sharpley, and then Chicago will enjoy a man advantage. They trail 2-0. A long pass that Bolderet couldn't handle. Back comes Savard. Savard into the spot. Shot saved. Rebound by Jack scores.
Now, one thing that the Canucks have done very well is the ability to cover up that rebound. Well, they didn't do so well this time as Lysiak will get the rebound from a Savard shot. You notice everybody watching Savard. Nobody looks around to find Lysiak streaking down that side and has an easy goal.
Well, that's just exactly what they needed, Gary. They had to get back in this hockey game. They couldn't go through this entire first period and be down 2-0.
In their favor, of course. But now with just one goal behind, here's that play. The puck came across to Secord. It was fired a little bit too quickly, and Secord only got the point of a stick on it and kind of cued it.
Marsh was one of the better Blackhawks in the two games in Vancouver. Rode is hammered into the board by Fox. A penalty coming up against Greg Fox of the Blackhawks. Now Rode and Feimster shove away at each other. Marsh is involved, and everybody is grabbing a player, and really not too much swinging going on, although Nil now and Feimster are squaring off. Fox is involved in another altercation. Now Marsh is going at it with Rota. That seems to be the main event, although along the board, Nil and Feimster are down.
The way things are going, we might be in for a long evening.
I didn't know which one to watch.
Well, there are three separate scraps going on. Gardner and Boldarev are simply hanging on to each other's jersey. And the same applies to Aldebrink and Patterson. But now Nil and Feimster are trying to get at each other again. Scapinello, the linesman, was between them, and then Ryan Bozak comes in to lend some help.
Well, you know one thing for sure, you're going to see a lot of 10-minute misconducts during this altercation. And Ron Wicks, he'll let the guys play if they concentrate on hockey. If they want to hit each other with good, solid body checks, he will certainly allow that. But this stuff that we're seeing right now, he has to put a stop to it. So Nil is heading for the dressing room as well as Feimster.
Slip it out in front, but it was picked off by the Blackhawks. Savard comes back over on the wing. Higgins shot, saved by Brodeur as he came way out of the net on Dennis Savard. And there will be some line juggling going on through the course of this hockey game. Dumped down the ice. Here's a two-on-one for Vancouver. Moline moving in. Scores!
Oh, what a move.
What a move by Moline. He had Tiger Williams for the decoy.
I think likely, Gary, Tiger Williams made that play happen as well as Moline. He went in and he was looking at Tiger Williams. Let's watch it here. He's looking at Tiger all the way in. And watch what Tiger Williams does. He busts for the corner of that net. Now Bannerman, he stands his ground all right. Moline makes him make the first move, then just pulls it by him.
Now once the defenseman had committed himself, then Moline was on his own, and did he make a nifty move. But for a forward, you have to size up the situation. Well, Moline did just that, saw that Tiger Williams had his defenseman come over to him, so he took in the mail and stuffed it in the corner. Excellent individual move by Lars Moline.
It seems, Gary, that Savard is almost trying to stick-handle his way right into the crease.
Well, he did that in both games in Vancouver, and I think a lot of it has to do with the way Brodeur has played net. He's come out to challenge, and, you know, as a forward, when you're in that scoring position, Bobby, you seem to second-guess. All of a sudden, you had some area to shoot at. The next thing you know, the goaltender has taken that angle away from you. So you figure, well, I guess I got to get into that crease area before I even put it in. And that's exactly what Savard was going through. And the goal he did score in game four, he shot the puck very aggressively, meeting each other, and not one of them backs down. Well, this is what has happened tonight. Intimidation, you're not going to intimidate either hockey club. It's the nonsense coming off the bench and hitting Lindgren with a stick. You know, that's uncalled for. That isn't going to help the Blackhawks in any way.
Isaac dropped it for Sharpley, overskated it, and back comes Fraser, 3-on-2. For Steele, shot, saved by Escobedo, who goes down on the rebound by Kadeem. Escobedo was able to hang on.
Now that's a big one for Tony.
Takes it to safety. For Moline, lead pass for Rota, going in alone. Darcy Rota scores. No, he hit the side of the net. He beat Escobedo and hit the side of the net.
Well, Tony threw that big stick out there, and that's why he deflected the puck just to the side of the net.
Way by Darcy Rota. Now he goes to his forehand, but Esposito gets that stick out there and just is able to deflect it and hit the side of the net. Isaac controlling it. Over to Murray. Murray having a little difficulty. Over to Wilson. Back to Murray. Moving in. Slap shot. It's wide. By Vancouver to Savard. Savard going back to the goal. He can really motor. Still has it. Back to the line for Wilson. Slap shot. Big rebound. Up over his stick. At the side of the net, it bounced right out in front to the line. Lysiak with a drive. Save. The puck at the side of the net. Loose. Savard trying to move out front. Steps is all over him. Savard has it again, and Lysiak couldn't get his stick on it. Back to Murray. A drive, and it's deflected wide. It went off Lindgren. Back to the point. Wilson unloads one. The save is made by Brodeur. Great pressure by the Blackhawks. Lysiak slaps it. It hit a leg in front and is finally clear. Here's a chance for Miner. As Miner breaks it across the line, he loses it to Murray. Now it's brought in, but it's offside. Peter Mars was being tied up by Lindgren in front of the Vancouver goal and could not get out. What pressure exerted by the Blackhawks on that power play.